this no, is the, not necessarily.
This is the sneakiest marketing campaign.
This is what I was going to do because it's a beta, but hang on, because I know where you're going with this. Go on.
Well, firstly, can I just say that the LGV Marcel to Avignon or whatever it is, if you look on Steam, they made that into a single standalone game, right? Mm. And they're selling that on Steam right now. So firstly, they've been dead lazy by taking exactly that content and putting it in the game and making you pay for it twice.
Yes.
I haven't paid for it. I don't want it.
No.
But what they're saying is if you pay for TS 2017, which at this moment they've rendered redundant, they don't even want it.
No.
They're saying if you buy all them four routes, whether you have them all or not, you get access to the beta for free. Mm. Now, what they imply there is, oh, you get the game, but what they were not going to say is once you get the beta, your access, it's a public beta for a certain amount of time. Then when it comes out of beta, you're still going to have to pay for it in February. So you either pay 30 quid for it now and have something you don't want, or just wait, you know, two months and then buy just the finished game.
What I was going to say was that if you haven't got all these routes, if you've only got Marseille to Avignon and the South Wales Coastal, if you haven't got the North Jersey or the Hamburg one, and you want the beta, and you I don't either, and you want the beta, the extra, 20, make you pay a 50.
I think it'd be around about 30 quid, I'd expect to see
quid.
There is an actual pricing for it.
If it's not, then it'll be, £25 a route? So it'll be 50 quid for both routes.
Hold on.
Unless they're greedy bastards, I don't think they'll do that. But we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Did they say they have put a price for it?
They have, yeah.
Have they said how much it will be?
Just one second while I look for it.
What's this?
For the Pioneers Edition.
The Pioneers thing.
I bet it's something like 40-odd quid.
No, it's not, actually.
I bet it'd be between 25 and 35.
How much are the most expensive TS software payway?
Well, what was it? The last
one would be like 25. Western Line, Scotland, something like that.
Any of the newer ones that just been released out of the blue, like, say...
The Marseille ones. Because the most expensive ones I've seen as a route is about 25 quid to 30 quid. Yeah. But they're selling TS software sometimes.
Ah, here we go. Here's pricings.
40.
Right, TS 2017 Standard Edition will cost you 25 quid.
Right.
And the Pioneers Edition will cost you 29 quid.
Not as bad as I thought it would be.
I didn't expect that to be like mid-40s.
Well, yeah, same as me, Brett. We had the same idea.
Well, I say 29 quid, I mean 30 quid, all but a penny.
But you get the Semmeringbahn thing, that German route, and the beta.
So it's a Semmeringbahn, that's Austrian.
It's part of the same flipping country. Never mind about geography. But you get that and the beta. But you're paying how much? You're paying what? 29 quid for it?
Yeah.
So, what would you rather do? Pay 25 quid for...
Well, 29 if you want the beta.
Let's
be fair, everyone's going to pay 30 because everyone wants the beta.
Yeah, because...
Not one idiot would pay 25 quid. Let's be honest.
Just for a standalone.
The thing is that... The problem is that... People were hyped about this 2017 is going to be running Unreal 4 and everything's fine. But the one thing I'm concerned about is the fact that... I forgot what I was going to say. Fuck, it's gone.
I think the misconception is they've hinted, no one's actually said it, they hinted basically that when the September comes and the update comes, you'll have the standard version and then you'll have the Unreal 4 version. Mm. So they made it out like there was two different variants of the same game. Which I'm really glad they said that they're nothing the same. They're completely unrelated. It's like a brand new game, new future. They're not looking back anymore. But when I watched the trailer, which was hilariously bad, by the way. Incredibly creepy.
Stop loading. On signal. Depart.
My favourite was the
brake. And not a single steam engine was used. Fuck them.
Apply brake. Not too much.
Not too much.
Don't go any further more brake. I'm
going to
watch the trailer.
We'll be disappointed.
So
That trailer is what would happen if Nerdcube did the tutorials for Precisely. Train Sim.
I think they should get Dan to do the trailers for TS. just to see what would happen.
I think no, it'd just be a crash compilation, the bumps and trailers.
Look at the trailer. Oh shit, I crashed.
iPad, too much.
I think too his much. Trailer would be it comes with four routes and you can crash on all of them.
That's my favorite trailer already. Let's do it.
50, 125. How fast was that? Many fast.
It just feels really lifeless.
Yeah,
this is clearly the last. Big thing they're gonna do.
Yeah, they're gonna. They're gonna stop supporting Train Sim now altogether, and they're gonna go straight over to World.
Yeah.
Right.
Well the mistake I think.
There's another thing that was brought up during the thing, as we've probably known. Will there be multiplayer? Well,
yes.
It says. Well, this is on the Train Sim there post about it, right? Will there be multiplayer? Multiplayer is still heavily in development and therefore will not feature in Train Simulator World, well, Train Sim World CSX Heavy Haul Beta. However, we are planning multiplayer as a key feature for TS World Experience and we'll have more details in the coming weeks.
Train Sim Experience?
So they lied about it being in the beta then, basically.
No, it is in
beta.
They didn't
actually say it was in the beta. They just said
the game
will have
it. They're saying multiplayer's not in the beta. They're just testing it at the minute to see if it'll work properly.
What I'm worried about is my computer is not powerful. By any means.
This is the second thing, which is really good.
Apparently, it's supposed to be easier on your PC.
Yeah.
I like the new logo they chose for Train Sim 2017. Sorry. I like the new logo.
2017.
Don't speak for fuck's sake.
If you run TS 2017 at whatever level your computer runs it at now, and you adjust the Unreal 4 one to look exactly the same, you will get triple the frame rates at best.
It
right,
makes
Unreal 4 will look three times better, run three times better, have physics, right?
Three times better.
Well, I don't think it has to have three times better because this version has physics.
The thing is,
better physics.
The thing is, Unreal 4 was built like a game engine. The game engine for Train Sim wasn't built as a game engine; it was built as a screenshot engine.
Yeah, pretty much. It wasn't.
It's good shit frames.
It was built on more of a base of a simulator, which is what it is. But if you look at stuff like Euro Truck. Which has
that was built
much
from the ground up to be a simulator.
Yeah, it was built up.
But it was built. Wasn't it built on its own engine though?
Yeah, it was built. So. It was built on its own engine, and from the start, it had the TSX similar engine stuff on it.
Yeah.
TS from the start didn't have that.
No.
It was from Railworks 2. It didn't have that at all. That started with Railworks 3.
I think it was a couple of years out of date when it was made.
Yeah.
And the thing is, when they were making that back, it would have been about 2000, but in and around the early 2006, 2007, it would have been, you know, in development.
MSTS was out in 2002, and it was a good few years between the two of them.
Right, it definitely came out in 2008, I think it officially launched.
Something like that, yeah.
I mean, considering the new version's been in operation, you know, it's been developing for 2 years now, one that we're going to release in February. A game engine back then was like opening a Word document and trying to tell the computer what the hell to do. Whereas Unreal 4 is like opening Gary's Mod, where it's got physics programmed into it and a sense of reality.
Hold on. You're comparing Unreal 4 to Gary's Mod. Don't compare anything physics-related.
In a roundabout way,
forget Gary's Mod. Unreal 4 is a sandbox. It's got text. I downloaded and started playing with it. You download Unreal 4 to start programming games. You click launch and you're a little man walking around the field. All you need to do is make models and program what the hell you want to do because it's got physics programmed into it.
Mm.
There's also another thing.
That's why the creator of Iron Horse House has been playing with it.
He has.
And now he's going to do his own game.
There is another thing about TS World that I actually find quite interesting.
Go on. A walking around feature.
I do want to play Train Simulator on my Xbox One. Is this still going to happen?
Yeah.
The Train Simulator World CSX Heavy Haul Beta will debut on Windows PC via Steam this December. The final version will release on Windows PC but via Steam in February, with the Xbox One version expected to release within the same window.
Yeah.
Right.
So therefore, hopefully, we'll have cross-platform play.
So, hang on, TS starts as a private sort of game where you could run it on your own computer. Yes. Now you can run it in front of your family and go, look, I can drive trains.
I can drive a train!
Look at me, Mum, I've done it! Look at me, I can drive a train!
Oh, the train just stops, you're just like, oh, yeah. Shit.
Oh, shit, you can't drive a train.
You know, I've just remembered something.
They've got this working on Xbox One. It's quite encouraging to think that they've got something right, because...
Yes.
I mean, there's no way the current version will run on Xbox One, because there's about 50 different commands you need. Yeah. So the fact that what they've done is they've made it a walking sandbox game, but happily there's a big fucking train right next to you.
Which
is brilliant, because that's what I said that TS lacked for ages.
The realism.
So the fact that you can walk up to a cab and sit down, and I presume what it'll be is very look orientated, and you can click on things and move it. That implies that it's very direct at what it's going to do.
Thing is, what I'm expecting as well is a high amount of realism.
Yeah, you will not believe how realistic this engine is.
The thing is,
not in that sense. So graphics, like engine-wise, so like failures and everything.
Well, the thing is that I suspect that they will now begin to start simulating. I mean, if you look at the class 159 with the HST, that's got DRA and cab heaters and cab lights and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They should be able, because people have been developing a roller coaster thing where it's like you sit in a chair and you can have it. Why you have an Oculus Rift on? And it's in a chair, and it's and you can program it to simulate the G forces and the ride on the roller coaster. So it feels like you're actually on a roller coaster. Why can't
essentially what they'll do with any add-on or content they'll do with this game, because the engine has physics programmed into it, all they need to do is encourage the engine to understand how much it weighs.
Guys,
and they don't because
and
that's,
then, and then
that's why.
That.
That's a big thing about DLC at the moment. The reason why it's not compatible is because the current version of the Train Simulator they have now, everything is animated to look like it's acting realistic. So the cab's way isn't physics-based. It's an animation that they've said, do this, and they've programmed the level to it. So
what do you reckon the wheel slip's going to be like?
The wheel slip might be... Have you ever experienced wheel slip on a foot plate?
Yes.
That's the amount of realism you will get in terms of animation. It will be a simulation. It will be an actual physics of the cab rattling.
I think yes.
I was gonna say, I saw the trailer just before this video, and I was gonna say you're right. The trailer is shit.
Oh, for the new version of the game. Oh, it's diabolically bad.
I got my hopes up. I thought that Facebook actually responded to me, and it just ended up being Ben liking my post.
That's nice. That's like them saying, well done.
We fucked up. Well done.
Yeah. Give a tiny violin for him.
Play the world's smallest violin.
I want to probably buy someone a pin badge thing, and it's got this tiny violin with it. Because why not?
Well, I happen to have my violin.
You happen to have my violin, just bear with me,
Oh.
Wait, you've got a violin? Awesome.
Who plays violin? Got a violin, guitar, drums, anything. Start playing Under Pressure bass now with the violin.
Well, I've been playing around with all sorts of wacky things through that.
I don't want to know. yeah, moving.
Okay then. Do you know I think what the biggest mistake I think they've done is if I were them, I wouldn't bother bringing out TS 2017. What I would simply do is keep it as TS 2016 and say, look, this is the new TS 2017 content package.
Just take away the 2016 and just keep it as Train Simulator.
Everyone will think that's a new game.
Why would they give you a choice between? Why can't you know when they've done like a tech update where they've done 2016, 2015, 2017, or 2016, whatever, and they've just given you the new, you've given you the new menu and they've given you everything else, but they don't give you any of the stock, any of the routes, any of the things. And it's a way of them making money. So why can't they just put that 2016 full thing with the Riviera and everything else? Why couldn't they have done that from 2015 to 2016? Why couldn't they have just done that rather than you having to pay an extra 25 quid?
You know what they should end up doing?
I know why.
Have a Steam era route for every fucking game they release.
Exactly.
Exactly.
The thing, Carl, I know what you're going to say, is the greedy bastard.
Yeah, the marketing department. It's quite evidently clear
they've jumped ship.
Let's put it that way, because when, what was it? Was it QG before? And then as soon as Dovetail
could come, we all jumped ship.
Because it was QG, EA, and somebody else.
There was a partnership between QG and EA.
Well,
but that was just Rail Simulator. I think they bought it outright and then released it. I think it was railsimulator.com. They went independent and they did it on Railworks on Steam. And I think it's only, was it 3 or 4 years ago they branded themselves as Dovetail?
It was 2014.
Because they were RSC before, weren't they?
It was RSC, which was RailSimulator.com. Like Dane said, when Dovetail came along, they all, obviously they had to do because they bought the flipping company, they all just jumped shit.
Oh, this will be good.
They are the company, that's the thing. They just said, we're buying everything outright, we're our own company now, and then they just branched off and made bigger things.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know.
Carry on, whatever you say.
why can't they? Because they had a tech update from 2015 to 2016, but you had to pay an extra 25 to 30 quid, or what was it? Three routes and three loads of Steam add-on stuff. Why couldn't they have just given you the Riviera Line 50s as part of the techware update, and then everything else you have to pay for? Because the gas turbine one, that's a big piece of simulation in order to get that right. Plus the other bit, which I can't pause, the other bit that came with 2016.
It was called the Cold Nets.
Norfolk Coal District.
Yeah.
I got really excited. I thought that Facebook actually was responding to me.
That's if you bought the Steam version. I didn't buy the Steam version of it.
No.
I've never bought any of them, but
when it came along, I thought actually this one might be worth it because, you know, credit where it's due, they did put a lot of effort into the Riviera pack.
Considering the fact they got Victory Works to do some of the shit for them.
Let's be honest, with their laziness, would you really slate them for bringing in third parties to make things better?
No. considering the fact we look at the Duchess and think,
maybe. No. You know, it's like the thing is that you expect. It's like they make such a big hype over every tech update. It's like, this is a brand new thing, it's going to be fantastic, and then you play it, it's actually really shit. I think the Unreal 4 engine will be the biggest update they've done in the past 10, 15 years.
You can clearly see, when you look back 2 years ago, when you realise that all the third party was making most of the game update for TS16, you realise that this version of the game, they've not actually gone, wow, they've sort of really faked it.
Yeah,
and they've made the package up essentially of everything they've already got. You can tell for 2 years in a row they've not given a shit about the game that they own.
The thing is, you can clearly tell the
entire team's been working on Unreal 4 and not said a word.
The thing is that what they've done, especially like if you do the homework, and it's basically like, the teacher asks, have you done the homework? You know, it's like, I want this homework in for, let's say, Friday, and it's Tuesday. It's like, okay then. So you're basically just, and it's basically something you've already done before, so you just scrap together all the stuff that you've already done, and then everybody else has done something new, and they go like, this is this, and this is that, and you look at your work, you think, we've already done this. I've just cobbled together work, and I ripped up the...
I think by the clever use of a sort of branding and marketing, it made you think it's a lot different than what they've already got. But
trust me, it's all
a big money cash in, because obviously they want money for this new game.
Oh yeah,
I don't blame them.
No,
it looks amazing.
Yeah.
But I'm surprised. I was half expecting it to come out as early access, if I'm brutally honest. Mm-hmm.
It is early access beta, but.
Not like as because they brought out the I think it's Dovetail Flight School early access. I thought maybe this one will come out early access as well. Mm. And essentially, it kind of is. But did any of you pick up on the fact that the fact that they said they're making packs?
Yes, they're making packs for this.
What's this one called? The heavy haulage. They said the heavy haulage pack will come out in February, which sort of hints that they've got a lot more content that they're not actually speaking about. So I reckon there's going to be a US pack, a Steam pack, and a German pack.
That's got me dreaming now. It's just like,
I have a
Steam
feeling
pack.
That Riviera in the 50s will be getting ported over.
You say about being ported over, Stuart. This is the thing. What about the roots? You know, in terms of like multiplayer, is there like a build feature in Train Simulator World, or is it something
there
like
will be,
you can sort of like build it in like Train Sim like 2016/17, port the route over, and you can use that as sort of like a multiplayer thing and the rest of it. And how's the multiplayer going to work? Are you going to create your own server, or do you have to borrow a server?
We only know the details which have been given. If you want to like
the details in the next few weeks, it says you will be able to create your own ship, but I don't know. Oh, actually, yes, it is for heavy haul, so you will be able to allow. To build your own ship.
So you'll be able to build your own routes, multiplayer routes, with the heavy.
I think so,
plan.
Yeah.
So
if Riviera in the 50s comes out, Steven builds like some fantastic route.
Yes.
We could all go on it for multiplayer.
Pretty much. But the funny thing is,
when this comes out, I think someone's got to make a massive speedway of about 10 parallel tracks, and we start. Someone models in like some sort of start line and we'll just go 3, 2, 1. That's what's going to happen.
The great race in Train Sim World.
You need the
it looks like the shooting star's having some kind of trouble.
Yeah, it's just like Thunder Rails drag race with Unreal 4 engine and multiplayer. Just think about that.
You can't. Because the problem is, everyone's been deluded into thinking they're playing a really good game for, about 8 years now.
Yes.
It's so hard to even comprehend how good this will be.
Yeah, it's like, the thing is we've got used to the TSX mode, the rain, the clouds and whatever, but now they're going to move over to an even more realistic...
Better running.
Physics-based simulation.
But it goes back to the point that you made, James, is that when you look at the game that we've got now, you have to put down a marker to tell it when to break or when to do this. But that's why content can't be made up, because it's all animated. You've got to tell the game what to do because it's thick.
It's like if I try and make a scenario. I think I've made one scenario that's worked, and that was on York to Newcastle. I think it was a modern version.
Close to sort of using content which has already been made. You'd have to remake it from scratch anyway. I'd rather remake it in this engine.
I think what you'd have to do is, with all the stock we've already got, A4s, A3s, the J. what you should really do, because all, you know all the parties that you've got? You've got JT, DT...
Mesh Tools, Victory
Mesh Tools, stop screaming, it's not helping you. All those kind of add-ons, apart except Dovetail, you've got all the others. Why can't they just collaborate into one? When this Unreal 4 engine comes out, I know that might sound like a bit blah, 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 and they won't do it.
So the problem you have with that is you've got one developer
for this new engine. Is bring out something that I think everyone will want.
Yeah.
It's something like from Days of the Big Four. Yeah. Everyone would jump on it straight away.
The thing is, if you did Euston to Carlisle. If you did King's Cross to...
I would like to see Settler Carlisle in the 1930s.
Yeah. If you could...
In its heyday, with water troughs.
Very specific.
With water troughs and all the way to Leeds, Stephen.
If you could do...
And the horse branch.
Including the bit to horse, yes.
If you could do...
In fact, that's a better idea.
And Stephen...
Can I fully extend off a theory that I have?
Go on.
Let Dane speak.
I've predicted a lot of things which have come true. Because I said this would come out in 2016, and it's coming out in 2016. Okay, Peter, but don't knock me. I think Mesh Tools is going to release all their stuff for Unreal 4.
I think that's why they're holding back for like the Fairburn. But also, what about the Super D as well? Are they holding back for that?
They're holding back on the Lancashire and Yorkshire for some bizarre reason. They've got a 4MT or a 3MT or tank or whatever it is, which they've ironically rendered in Unreal 4 for whatever reason, we don't know.
Dane, that's a standing
thing. And the Super D is way beyond finished because fucking Matt Pennystone or whatever is previewed it months ago, so why are they not releasing it? Unless they've stripped it back, copied it, and re-rendered it for Unreal 4 and it's been waiting for a release.
This is something else I want to bring up as well. Although Unreal 4 engine is going to be all super duper rest for it and Train Simwell is going to offer multiplayer rules for it, that's all fine in one sense. But I feel so sorry for the developers like Digital Traction, Victory Works, Just Trains, etc. All that sort of stuff. You think of all the DLCs and the add-on packs that they've made, like especially like as I'm doing now, Victory Works, like the S160s, and DT are going to release in my Bailey, Adam's Radial Tank Engine. You think they're making it in a sense, a TS2016-17 game. They're going to have to take each and every one of those models, in effect, strip it right down, if not having to completely duplicate those models from scratch, just so they can go into this new Transim world. Not unless they can just take the exact same model, modify it, and just port it on.
I mean, I felt really sorry for Just Trains in 2008, where they were making essentially MSTS models, crossing the fingers, hoping that it would be good enough, and putting them in railbacks, and they look like a crock of shit. They didn't know what they were doing. Yeah. The world evolves, and unfortunately, everyone's stuck with the game for far too long. Mm. So people have learned how to do it, and now everyone's going to be like, going, oh, we don't know what we're doing.
Yeah.
This should have happened like 3 years ago.
It should have done. I think personally, TS has become one of these games where
I find that a lot of people demand that they have rights when they go. It's so funny. Anyway, carry on.
TS should be a game where multiplayer should have been a thing right from the start, because Trains was glitching in and out of multiplayer. Every other game that I can think of that came out when TS first sort of came about in 2006, some of the, about 90% of them had multiplayer. TS has not had multiplayer at all, and the reason why is because they were so based on it being realistic. They weren't basing it on the players, they were basing it on the realism of the simulation. They weren't basing it on the people that are actually going to play it.
You can see it in, I don't know if it happens to you, but say if I load up one of the first routes from Rail Simulator, say Bath and Temple or whatever, and I place down a consist from the Riviera pack in the 50s.
It lags like hell.
If I look at my engine, it drops my frame rate. What they've done is they've overloaded all the models, because what they've done is they if you look at the script for every single one of the models now, it's got billions and billions and billions of commands because there's no simulation there. They've got to tell it to sway, they've got to tell the wheels to work this way. That's why they couldn't get wheel split working, because they had to tell it to work. So they've overloaded every model, every aspect of the game engine with so many commands that it's not consistent enough. And they did, someone made, I read it on a thread somewhere, but they did, multiplayer exists for this game. But it was just, it was axed because they got two people on a server. And because, you know, your game stops and forgets it's having a stroke every 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Which reflects in online. So you just disappear. Or your engine just stop for about 5 minutes because it's amplified, it's online. And then when you take into like a fact that they've rendered 70 miles of actual stuff, the game just shits itself. I don't know what to do.
Going back to TSW, I found made mine found the specs for it.
Hang on, you hush your jingle mouth. Come on, Brett.
Okay. Tracing World CSX Heavy Haul Beta Anticipated Minimum PC Specification Operating System 64-bit Windows 7 Service Pack 1 Windows 8, Windows 8.1 or 10 Processor.
That's odd, we're on Windows Pack 2 for Windows.
Hang on. Processor 2 gigs, dual core, 64-bit CPU.
I'm knackered then.
Hang on, can we do a top trumps whilst you're reading these out? Can we compare each bit with the current one?
Go on.
Hang on, if I open Steam. Because they'll put it in perspective a bit. I'm guessing I've fucking got my fingers crossed this is going to be better. Because if this turns out bad, I'm going to look
Your point is fucked, basically.
I'm standing
what
by...
What you're hoping that the Unreal Engine 4 will require less PC specs.
Yeah.
Well, at the moment, the process is lower, so...
Most likely it will require less.
The thing is, Dane, if you're wrong in the process...
You look like a massive spoon.
You will.
Although I currently look a massive spoon. Can I just ask where this information... Is this come from just user speculation?
A mate of mine pasted it. It's one of the admins on Versum Users Group.
Oh, that group.
Oh, those people.
Oi. I love you, I'm part of that group as well.
Is this minimum or recommended? What does he say about
anticipated
it?
Anticipated is what he says.
Anticipated. So we can't really go on that, really.
Right. But it's just what they, it's just what they
the
believe.
Processor, what was the processor again?
2 gigs, dual core, 64-bit.
The minimum... The minimum operating system for TS as it is 2.8 gigs.
Right. And what that, was and what
the processor on this one, or what it says here, is 0.8 less.
But this, hang on, this is minimum specs. This is the specs for running on low.
Fair enough. 8 gigs of RAM, memory.
That's two what gigs. I've got at the moment.
Shitting out.
Yeah, pretty well.
Okay, hang on, graphics. DirectX 10. With GPU and 2 gigs of video RAM.
This says... this pisses me off. They say 512 megabytes of pixel shader 3.2. I can guarantee all of us, including you, Steve, have got more than this, and it still runs like a...
Storage! Here we go. This is the big number. 40 gig.
40
gig! Oh, 40 gig! Wow. 40 gig, that's 22 less than GTA 5 at the moment.
Yes.
40 gig?!
At launch, GTA 5 on PC was 60 gig.
What's the gig for the current TS?
Can I just say, oh my god.
Minus DLC, I presume.
I'm calculating my current Railworks folder, and it's still ramping up, so I'll let you know when it's finished.
I'm gonna join you on that, Dane. Hold on. I'm going to join you on that.
I'm going to join you as well, actually, just to see what it will do. Just hold on.
For anyone who can see,
can I just say I've breached 30 gig?
Yeah.
And it's still going. I've passed 40 gig and it's still going. I'm getting a bit bored now as I've breached 60 gig.
Yeah.
It's still going.
You just keep going.
Hold on.
Have you breached it yet?
Does it have an estimated time when it will be done?
It's still doing it. It's mine's doing it now. Oh god.
I have reached 75 gig and it's still going. Oh, I've passed 80, so my favorite
I'm doing mine now, so...
How do I do that?
Like, gig day.
What is it? Is it inside?
Go to your Steam apps common, and then right-click on Railworks and click properties.
Mine's gone through a megabyte, it's down a gigabyte now. So size on disk.
I've hit 40 gig and it's still going.
Hold on. Guys.
No, it's not finished yet.
Guys, you lot are fucking stupid. On Steam, you can literally see how much it's using of your fucking disk.
That
tells you if you were to buy the game on Steam.
No. Right click on Train Sim, then go to local files at the top, it will say disk usage.
Yeah, but that won't take into account an SSS pack. It won't take into account.
Yeah. Yes, it will. Is it?
I don't think it will.
How much?
Well, no, call me stupid, but this is nearly under. this is just my fault, just short of 140 gig.
Oh! Yeah, 40 gig at the minute.
I've already breached 13 gig.
I think we can say that the Unreal 4 slightly tops this one.
Yeah, I think so. I think
slightly.
So.
I guarantee that there's only about 10% worth of content in Unreal 4, but
yeah, Dane, yours may be shorter than 140, you're just shy of 140 gig, Dane. But remember,
it's about 180.
Mine is still climbing and it's breached 115 at the moment. But don't forget, I've made a lot of reskins, so I've had duplicates of models, so I'm going to be a lot higher.
Well, come back to that later.
You come back to that. Make me a brew, pizza, right, and garlic bread, and they'll tell you what.
I'll bake you a cake.
You have to go back to program files and then Steam folder, left click on it, and it goes.
I have like 5 to 10 DLC things.
What we're going here,
minus 60,
well, on the basis
19.
That we're going here, Dane, that I will be able to run TS World on a decent amount of settings without even trying.
Yes, that's what we're saying.
If you discard everything but your computer's speed, the Unreal 4.
Okay, hang on. I've got the specs on the side of my PC as a sticker. I've now got Windows 10 on it, so I've got an Intel Core.
Right.
Hang on. I've got an Intel Core i3. I don't know how powerful that is.
Right.
4 gig of RAM, DDR3.
Right.
Terabyte of hard drive, and that's it.
Yeah, I think you've got the same computer as
I do. You not have a separate video card that isn't internal?
That's
for
no,
you.
That, yeah.
Why is the music coming through my computer? What?
What are you doing?
Right, it's done calculating.
It succeeded 112.
I genuinely music play.
I'm just nearing 50 gigs.
Why is it playing music, Dane?
It's not now. There was I don't know unless one of you was playing music. That
was probably an advert.
Right, mine's done calculating.
Go on, what is yours, Steve?
Mine as it currently stands, mine contains 391,033 files, which brings it to 28,327 folders, which is an equivalent.
What?
Is 153 gig.
Is that on the disc?
That's all.
That's on the disc and size.
Okay, I'm definitely not going to stop that. I just want to figure out how to do this.
I'm just going to see if I can. I'm just going to see how far mine gets.
Mine's on
130 at the minute.
Mine's on 73 at the moment.
78.
Brett, can
75.
I'm just
did you say
yours
was in gig?
Mine's on both size and disk is 153 gig.
Yes, go ahead, Dane.
I'm 135.
Can you please let Dane speak before I kill one of you?
No.
Don't wait for me to start or finish talking for me to do that. The specs that you were given, did this explicitly say whether it was dual core for the processor?
Yes, it said single core. It said dual core on it.
Dual
core 64-bit.
88 gigabytes.
Wow. 90 gigabytes. Stephen, how many files and folders did it say you had?
My one contains 391,033 files, which is 28,327 folders.
I've got 372,823 files and 24,249 folders.
Mine's still counting. It's 107.
Okay,
mine's
so I've been doing some digging online to see if I can find recommended specs for the game, not just minimum specs.
Recommended.
So the recommended to run it on full whack specs for TS is a dual core 3.16 gigahertz processor.
Well, the thing is, I'm running a mine's a 4150. So what is that? 4150 hertz or something? 4.1 hertz.
Just look it up on Google.
No, it's like 4.1 hertz. That's more than.
Is it an ADM? Is it ADM 4100?
No, mine's Intel Core.
Master,
Intel Core i3 4150.
I don't even know what my processor is.
Yours is a 3.5 gigahertz processor.
Mine.
No wonder I struggle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mine's
Can I just say that I've got a quad core 4.0?
Yeah, because you. What? Yeah, because
have you ever thought? Have you ever thought of clocking it to 5, where you will literally be able to reach out and touch God?
Yes.
Well, there is that.
You have six cores.
Oh, my processor is 3.6 gigahertz, so I'm pretty crap.
That's to be honest with you, it's even 2.4 is a really good processor. Like I said before, the game is just so shit you don't even know it.
If you had a 4.7 processor, would you push it to 5.2?
Steve,
what?
You know yours was like 300. What was it? 300 odd files. 300,000 odd files.
Mine was 391,033 files.
Almost 400.
Mine's at 500. Mine's at 550,000 files.
What?
And 157 gigabytes. Right, it's just stopped now. 555,844 files, which converts it into 35,341 folders. And the space on disk, the size on disk, 158 gigabytes, which is 170,436,100.
Can we just establish that this is a lot bigger than?
Yeah, it's like this is mostly reskins that I've downloaded, sound packs, and freeware.
How does that work though? I've got more stuff than you.
Don't touch it. No, Barry, don't touch it.
Don't touch me, bed.
That's your department!
Don't touch me, bed.
How'd you get in there?
A bit shit.
Hang on, I'll get you out.
Lavange!
I'm waiting for him to yell Bruce Forsyth at this problem.
Bruce Forsyth, Bruce
Forsyth.
Does anyone want to hear mine?
Hello?
Hang on. What, Brett, what are you going to say before we all forget?
Could you imagine AP stuff in Unreal 4? Like the
sound pack thumper in Unreal 4.
Ooh! Right. Realistic clag for once.
Realistic clag? What's the effect? You choke as soon as you get in it, or what?
Yeah. But one thing they're able to animate in UE4 is you know how in TS if you go under a bridge or in a tunnel, the smoke goes through the bridge.
I want it to actually go through
the roof of the tunnel.
Steve said this.
Particles collide.
Steve said this where. He said this in a Skype call a few weeks ago, where why can't you have it where in real life it just hits the head of the tunnel and then the smoke comes down and you can see
the problem is, in the current version of the game, an emulated effect is an individual sort of point.
Yes.
No.
So you have to tell a thousand points what to do, which would light your computer to shit.
Yeah, yes. but...
Your computer, you would get to a bridge and your computer would just go...
You say that, Dane. But
the predecessor
to Train Simulator as it is now, Microsoft Train Simulator,
you go through any bridges and tunnels, it did it, and it's a lot older game.
Yes, but that's because
to be honest with you,
but the engine that runs on doesn't have to compute as much as rain, clouds, the simulation, wheel slip.
Yeah, but even when the game was very first released as Rail Simulator back in 2008, that pretty much had nothing on it. It was extremely basic. So why wasn't it implemented then?
It's the same problem. You've got to tell 1,000 different particles to stop. MSTS did, it just basically stopped emulating smart when it went in the tunnel.
That's basically because the thing is, if you listen to, I think there's an SMD documentary that did in like 1980 something. I think it was 1986. And if you listen to one of the driver's descriptions of them going through one of the tunnels, it's like they could see the cinders falling off the tunnel and down, and you couldn't stick your head outside of the cab because you'd just get your face covered in cinders. But then again, you can't simulate that in train sim, but you could simulate the sight of it. But then, like Dane said, you'd have to put like 15,000 things in it to stop your computer just having a massive stroke and dying.
Essentially, what MSTS would have done is in the code, it would have said for the length of the tunnel, it would have said stop emulating smoke, and then as soon as you come out again, it looks like it bellows out again. Which is a really clever effect of making it look like it's got a lot more physics than it genuinely has.
Yeah,
but that's all it ever is.
It's like it would sort of go. You've entered the tunnel. Stop emulating smoke. You've exited the tunnel, start emitting smoke again. But the thing is that they'd have to time it to every tunnel. So if a tunnel was, I don't know, 100 yards long, you'd take Gasworks Tunnel, which I don't know how long Gasworks Tunnel is.
You write it into the tool itself, so it would do it automatically for you, but it's a simple thing to do.